Hello my dear friends, in this video we will going to learn another example that is based on energy balance for a closed system 3. So what is here, the situation is given that a rigid tank, so this is your rigid tank, that means a rigid tank, that means the volume is fixed, the rigid tank, this is your rigid tank, right? Divided into two parts, parts one and the part two, divided into two parts, two equal parts. That means if there is a volume is V, then this volume V by 2 and this is your V by 2, divided into two equal parts, right? Initially, one side of the tank contains 5 kg water at 200 kilopascal and 25 degree centigrade, right? So this is your water. This is a complete water, high pressure, this is the very high pressure, 200 kilopascal, and at a room temperature, approximately very low temperature, 25 degree centigrade. So this is in form of water, and other side is evacuated. So this side is evacuated, that means there is no any pressure in this side. So the pressure is zero here. So the pressure is evacuated zero, right? So there is no any pressure, this is zero pressure, vacuum, evacuated, right? Evacuated. Now the partition is then removed. If this partition is removed, if you remove this partition, if this partition is removed, then the water will expand. Obviously, if the water is in a compressed region, compressed zone, that means there is a very high pressure, water is in compressed, when the partition is removed, the water will fill the entire tank, and when it fills the entire tank, the volume is increased and consequently the pressure will reduce. So the final when it fills throughout the container, so its pressure will reduce and volume will increase. So the partition is there removed, the water is expanded into the entire tank, right? The water is allowed to exchange heat with the surrounding until the temperature of the tank return to its initial value, right? So what is given, if this partition is removed, number first, now what is the situation? The situation is given a rigid tank of two partition, equal partition, and in one partition there is a high pressure liquid, that means water 5 kg and at 25 degree centigrade. Right, number second, number third, when the partition is removed, the entire fluid which is in already present in the first partition will throughout expand and it full cover to the entire tank. So when it covering to the entire tank, its pressure will reduce and volume will increase. So when its pressure will reduce, so it is expand, so it we expand, so there may be chance to take heat. There may be a chance to heat will into the system. So this is heat in, and this is also given, or the water is allowed to exchange heat with its surrounding until the temperature of the tank return to its initial temperature. That means initial and final temperature are same. So initial and final temperature same. So what is that, heat will in until P2 becomes T1 after expansion of water, right? So number first, what is to find that, determine the volume of the tank. So volume of tank is what, number first. What is number second? Final pressure, that means P2 is what. Number third, what is that, heat transfer for this process, that means Q in. Okay, now see, 1/2 of rigid tank is filled with liquid water while the other side is evacuated. Then the partition between the two parts is removed and water is allowed to expand and fill the entire tank while the temperature is maintained constant, right? The volume of the tank, final pressure and the heat transferred to be determined, right? So now what is the assumption? The assumption number first, system is stationary. System is stationary. That means what is that? Delta E of system is equal to delta U, right? We assume number second, what is the assumption? Number second, what is the assumption? The volume of the rigid tank is Q. That means volume of tank is fixed, rigid tank, right? Number third, what is that? There is no electrical shaft and any other kind of work is involved. That means the expansion against vacuum. So since expansion against equated space, such type of expansion is called unrestrained expansion. What is called? Unrestrained expansion. Right? So in this case, the work transfer is zero. Boundary work basically is zero. And there is no any electrical heating shaft work, so the work is zero. So the net work is zero. So for that, there is no any, so work transfer during process 1 to 2 is zero. Check. Right? Now, what is the system? We take entire container act as a system. We take entire container as a system. So this is your closed system, right? So this is your closed system. This is your closed system. There is no any mass transfer. This is your closed system, right? Right? Okay. Now, initially the water in the tank exists in so observation. What is the observation here? See, initially the water in the tank, exists as compressed liquid. That means state one. What is the state one? Compressed liquid. Why this is compressed liquid? See the pressure. So since, very important, this is very important, since its pressure, how much? 200 kilopascal is greater than P saturation. P set at how much? 25 degree centigrade. How much it is? It is 3.1698 kilopascal. Right? So the pressure which is present at the state 1 is much higher than the saturation pressure. So corresponding through that pressure, the liquid is in compressed liquid. So whenever the pressure of the system, that means if you write always, the pressure of a system is higher than the saturation pressure at given temperature, so that saturation is called compressed liquid. What is called? Compressed liquid. So this is the pressure of the system is 200 kilopascal, and this pressure is much more higher than the saturation pressure at a given temperature. So the phase present, it is in saturation compressed liquid, right? Number first. What is the number second? Number second is that approximating the compressed liquid as a very important saturated liquid at a given temperature. So the second approximation is that when the fluid is present in a compressed region and the compressed liquid behave as a saturated liquid. So all the properties of a compressed liquid is corresponding to that of a saturated liquid at a given temperature. So if this is a PV diagram, so initially it is a compressed, so there is a pressure, like suppose this is a pressure. Let's suppose this is our pressure and this pressure is 200 kilopascal. Let's suppose. And at 200 kilopascal, this is point number one. Let's suppose this is point number one, liquid, right? After it is expansion, the volume will increase. So volume will increase and pressure will reduce. So it is behave like that. Volume will increase, pressure will increase. So it is, I think, this point, and this is the reduced pressure. So pressure will reduce. So what is the final pressure is to be determined. What is this pressure? Right? What is P2? This is a P1. Okay, so this is P2. P2 is what? So this is point number two. So it is in this zone, whether it is two phase mixture or not, let's check. No problem. So now state point one. So a state point one is compressed liquid, right? Compressed liquid, and compressed liquid behave as a saturated liquid at temperature 25 degree centigrade. So what is V1? V1 is nothing, it is Vf at 25 degree centigrade. So Vf is what? 0.001 003 meter cube per kg. We can take approximation 0.001 meter cube per kg. Okay, so this is point number one, right? And mass is given. So initial volume we can easily calculate. So then the initial volume of water. Initial volume of water, what is that? V1, what is that? M into specific volume. What is M? 5. What is 0.001? So it is 0.005, right? Meter cube. This is the initial volume, right, of water. Now, so what is the total volume of tank? So total volume of tank, why? Because it is equal parts 2 into V1. So this is 2 into V1, 0.005. So what is that? 0.01 meter cube. Okay. So this is your number first. This is first. Okay. Total volume of So first question, the volume of the tank. So this is the volume of the tank, no problem. Now number second is final pressure, right? Okay, so state 2, what is the volume? V2. What is V2? Volume of tank divided by mass. So volume of tank is how much? 0.01. What is mass? 0.05, 5 kg. Sorry, this is not 0.05, 5 kg. Okay, 5 kg. So what is the volume? 0.002 meter cube per kg. Just double total volume or specific volume, don't bother about that, right? So this is your final volume, state number 2. So since this volume is at temperature, how much? 25 degree centigrade. Why? Because T1 initial and T2 initial is 25 degree centigrade. So at this state, 25 degree centigrade, what is Vf? What is Vf? 0.001003 meter cube per kg. What is Vg from table? 43.34 meter cube per kg. That means this is your Vf and this is your Vg, right? So see, the V2 is in between this. So from observation, you can say that V2 is less than Vg, is greater than Vf. You can say that or not? This you can say that, right? So hence, what is your conclusion? Hence, water is a saturated liquid vapor mixture at final state, right? At final state 2, right? And at that final state 2, that means a liquid vapor mixer, and liquid vapor mixer, the pressure at point 2 is what? P saturation. Why? Because in this region the pressure, throughout the pressure and temperature are same. So in this region, what is the pressure is there? The same pressure is there. So at this pressure, what is the pressure saturation here? So this is your how much at 25 degree centigrade. So what is saturation pressure here? 3.1698 kilopascal. That means this is approximately 3.17 kilopascal. So this is your P2. So this is your 200. This is 3.17. And this is your kilopascal, right? And this is your process. And why this is dotted line? Why? Because there is a irreversible, right? This is irreversible process. Constant expansion is irreversible. So this is a pressure, Rao. Number third. What is number third? Number third. So if you write number third here, no problem. Number third. Number third is that heat transfer for the process. So we know that Q122 minus W122 is equal to delta U. What is the condition for closed system, right? एंड स्टेशनरी सिस्टम वेयर द चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज जीरो एंड चेंज इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज जीरो. दैट्स वाई डेल्टा ई ऑफ सिस्टम इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा यू. राइट नाउ सी दैट. सो हेयर देयर इज नो एनी वर्क. दिस इज व्हाट दिस इज टोटल वर्क इंट्रैक्शन ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस. टोटल वर्क इंट्रैक्शन ड्यूरिंग प्रोसेस 1 to 2. इट्स इंक्लूड व्हाट इज इंक्लूड बाउंड्री वर्क. इट्स इंक्लूड शाफ्ट वर्क. इट इंक्लूड इलेक्ट्रिकल वर्क. सो देर इज नो एनी शाफ्ट वर्क फ्रॉम योर ऑब्जर्वेशन. सो दिस इज जीरो. एंड एक्सपेंशन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस इज बाउंड्री वर्क. सो एक्सपेंशन अगेंस्ट इवेक्यूएटेड चेंबर. सो द बाउंड्री वर्क इज जीरो. और यू कैन से दैट दिस इज आवर सिस्टम. सो दिस इज आवर होल सिस्टम. देयर इज नो एनी डिस्प्लेसमेंट. और यू कैन से दैट फॉर रिजिड सिस्टम द चेंज इन वॉल्यूम इज जीरो. सो देयर इज नो एनी बाउंड्री वर्क. इंस्टेड ऑफ दिस इफ दिस इज अप्लीकेबल. If this is applicable when we take this is our as a system, very important. When we take this is our system, this is applicable when we take this is our system. If this is our system, then we say that expansion against vacuum. So this is zero. No problem. So there is no any work. So there is no any type of work. So this is zero, right? So the heat transfer 1 to 2 is what mu2 minus u1, right? Now what is u1? U1 is uf, right, at 25 degree centigrade. Why? Because saturated liquid, and this is your 104.83 kilojoule per kg, right? And but U2 is in two-phase mixer, two-phase region. So you have knowledge about dryness fraction. So for a dryness fraction, we can calculate another approach. What is that? V2 you have. V2 is equal to Vf plus x2 vf vg minus vf you have. So you have v2. What is your v2? V2 is 0.002. What is your vf? Approximately 0.001 plus x2. What is your vg? 43.34. and what is your VF? Same 0.001. So from here you can easily calculate X2. So X2 is 2.3 cos 10 to the power minus 5. So this is a dryness fraction. So once you have a dryness fraction, then you have U2. What is U2? UF. So you have UF, right? What is U? UF. So you have UF 104. You can write like that. So this is your. So what is U2? You can write like that also. One second. So you have U2. U2 is UF plus X2 यू जी माइनस यू एफ एट हाउ मच, 25 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, राइट। सो यू हैव यू एफ, यू एफ हाउ मच फ्रॉम टेबल, 104.83 प्लस एक्स टू यू हैव 2.3 cos 10 टू द पावर माइनस 5, एंड यू एफ यू जी दिस इज योर 2304.3। सो यू कैन कैलकुलेट इजली 104.88, वेरी स्मॉल चेंज पर केजी। पुट ऑल दिस वैल्यू हेयर, वॉट इज मास, 5 u1, 104.88 u2, 104.83, so this is your 0.25, so this is positive. So heat is transferred to the water, so heat is transferred to the water. Okay, right, thank you very much.